Hi, my name is Ben. In this video, we will integrate the Cube system we set up in the previous video into an Allen Bradley PLC and take a look at the diagnostic messages in the PLC and in the web server. The engineering software we will be using is Logix Designer. Before we get started, make sure you have done the following. Import the 56535 Ethernet IP EDS file into Logix Designer. Note the input and output bytes in use. You can find them in the informational fields in the Configurator tab of the bus node. Create a new project. Insert the bus node into the I/O configuration. Name the device and insert its IP address. If necessary, set the right revision number. This value corresponds to the firmware version of the bus node and can be seen in the status tab in the web server. Insert the length of input and output data according to the values on the web server configuration tab. Press OK. Download the project to the PLC. If an error occurs on any I/O module in the Cube system, the diagnostic messages can be seen on the bus node's input data. In this case, we caused two short circuits on port 6 of the 56601 module. The first two bytes in the list belong to the system state virtual module. They provide information on the current state of the bus node. The diagnostic data for the I/O modules are transmitted by the virtual diagnostics module. They start at the input data byte 2. Now, every diagnostic message is composed by 8 bytes. Bytes 2 to 9 contain the first diagnostic message, and bytes 10 to 17 the second message. You can also see the information on the diagnostics tab in the web server. For more and detailed information about all diagnostic messages, check the manual. Well done, that's it! If you want to learn more about the Cube67 Ethernet IP system, in combination with an Allen Bradley PLC, check out our tutorials or visit www.moelektronik.com to find your contact person.